Welcome to show number 614. My name is Larry Herbeck, Box Lives, Major Nelson. We're rolling here with the end of January, beginning of February 2018. Thank you for joining us. We've got Laura with us. Hi, Laura.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Good.
Let me give you a little volume over there.
Oh, sweet.
I was playing around with your volume a little bit.
Crank me up.
Well, I don't want to do that. You don't want to blow everyone out. But then across from you, the man I have to turn down all the time.
I was just going to say that.
Mr. Jeff Rubenstein. Hello, Jeffrey.
Hi.
Now, this
Hi
is,
from Muteland.
This is an awkward show.
Why is that?
Well, it's a couple things. So we're recording this at the end of the week. And in just a few days is the Superb Owl.
Yes, you've never seen an owl
The Superb Owl.
Never.
So, which is the Eagles versus the Patriots. And for those of you in the United States, you know it's the Super Bowl, big deal. And Jeff is a huge Eagles fan.
So I don't know if you know, but there is a an indicator that that is just very reliable on who's going to win the Super Bowl. And that is cherry picked the Xbox Live session that they do where they pit one player from one team versus one player for the other team in Madden on Xbox One.
Yeah, this has been going on for years.
Right. Oh, my God. What was the first Super Bowl?
I think the first one was Lombardi, right?
Yeah, I think it was. some guy from the Packers, Bart right. Starr was right. playing Xbox. This happened this week, and I will link out, and you can watch LeGarrette Blount, the running back who came over from the Patriots, you know, wised up and came down to Philly and is playing for the NFC champion Eagles, and against some guy who's going by Gronk.
Yes.
Oh, I don't know. Miss
good old Rob Gronkowski. You know, I've known him. He and I have done some stuff together.
You went to one of these before, I
well,
remember.
Well, we did an event. Rob and I did a couple of events. One of them was a Halo event where I flew out to Gillette Stadium, which is right down the street from where my sister lives. So that was a tough one. But yeah, Rob's a great guy. We just had a grand time. We had fun. That's all I'll say.
So if you don't know who won, I won't spoil it, but I will link out to it in the show notes. So you should watch that.
Do you have a history of how accurate this predictor has been?
No, I have no idea. I'm just making this up because the Eagles have to win. That's it.
Laura's going with hard data.
I know.
As any good analytical scientist, she's like, give me the data.
I like the art. The art of making stuff up and of selective data sets, and you actually want to know the facts.
Yes. Why you show up in a clown suit and she's in a lab coat.
Yeah. This is one of my better t-shirts.
Anyway, we're here. We're having a good time. It's great to be back. Were we here last week?
I can't remember.
We weren't. By the way, a lot of emails have been asking us, also folks asking on Twitter, working on the next video show.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we don't have a date yet, or else I would have told you guys. But I know that is a request. I'm headed out to Rare next week.
Right.
To talk Sea of Thieves, which I've been playing. I know, Laura, you've been playing that a little bit.
I have.
And
we'll talk about that later. Or now, if you want to talk about
it
now.
You know what? Let's
we're here.
Let's go ahead. We're among
friends. Dove right in. Yeah, we've already walked the plank on this.
Why don't you go? Thank you. Well done, Laura.
It was the other night.
Yes.
And I finally had time to play.
Yes, you're busy.
And I was really excited to play Sea of Thieves. And guess who was online? Larry was online.
That was me.
Oh. And Larry was playing Sea of Thieves.
Did you two play together?
No.
I'm representing the fans, the listeners who want you two to play together.
It actually gets better. So Laura texts me, she's like, "Hey, do you want to play Sea of Thieves?" And we were in the middle of an epic sea battle, of which there are many in Sea of Thieves. And I finally responded to her like 10 or 15 minutes later.
Yes. So I said, "Can I join your crew?"
Yeah.
Yar
crew. She was having a little bit of fun.
And you said, "We're full. Sorry."
Always in character, this one.
I know.
I felt terrible because we were full, and so you went out of the high seas kind of alone.
I did.
You know, there was you're a strong young woman. You decided to do it yourself. Adventurous, yes.
Try out my sea legs.
Yep.
On my own.
Yeah.
And so just hit the random button and then joined.
So Laura was actually I go into matchmaking frequently. I know you've done it, so you did it this time. So tell us what happened.
Yeah. So the first crew I joined was three guys who had lost their fourth. I don't know how, but I randomly showed up in their game.
They have no idea how lucky they were to have you show up. They have no idea.
They're like, "Who's this person? Who's this lollipop person?"
Yeah.
I'm like, "Hello." And they're like, "Oh, hi."
Yeah.
And they were nice. And so we we adventured to an island.
So you had your headset on. They all had their headsets. You guys were rolling full voice. Yep.
That's the way to play it.
Exactly. Rolling full voice. They were trying to, they'd already started a mission.
Sure. So you came in mid-mission.
I came in mid-mission and they had just landed on an island and they had their clues and they had found out the first clue, but still working on the second clue.
Right. Because as you solve the first one, the second one will reveal itself on the scroll in a very dramatic fashion.
Exactly. So I pulled up the clue, and I'm like, I know what we should do. All we have to do is find this cave with an overhang, and then it said raise a torch. We all have lanterns. We can try raising our lanterns up and jumping around and seeing if that will reveal it. So we're scouring the island looking
for
this cave.
They have no idea how lucky these guys were. They have no idea. Do you remember their gamer tags? You should go look on recent players.
I should look at recent players and say who they were. They were really, really kind. And unfortunately, while we're running around the island looking for the cave, someone says, hey, where's our ship?
Uh-oh, classic Sea of Thieves moment.
Yeah. Where did the ship go? And I was like, what? I just saw it. It was right over there. And so we all run back.
Right, to the beach.
To the beach. And sure enough, no ship.
What happened?
We don't know.
Because there's a couple things that could have happened.
Yeah, this has happened to me a few times.
Okay.
Is you're wandering on the island and someone just comes in there and lights it up.
Swoops in and off they go.
And they can basically hijack your ship and they can either sink it or sail it away.
Mm-hmm. But unfortunately, they let me on the really bad news about that was that they had already made three missions completed.
And they had
three chests
that were
in
on board.
That ship.
So you got jacked. Yeah, yeah.
And
that's part of it.
They were gone.
Yeah, Jeff is right. We learned that a long time ago. You got to leave one person on the ship so that you can ring the alarm bell.
Right, if attackers come.
Yeah, attackers come.
So I figured out, I tweeted this as well, we didn't know what to do. Like, we have no ship. We're just stranded on this island. What do we do?
Yeah, options and then scuttle ship.
No, so you can actually go to the menu?
Yeah.
Oh. Yep. So, I didn't know that. Okay, awesome. That's faster.
Yeah.
But apparently there is a mermaid that starts swimming
right when you
near
lose
where
your
you
ship.
Are.
Yeah,
yes,
yeah.
When you're too far away from your ship.
I believe it's a merman.
I think it's a merperson.
Yeah, okay. It's tough
not
to
really
say.
Sure. I don't know that there is
And usually you don't have a lot to check them out because you're trying to swim to get out of the water because usually there's a shark on your backside.
Yes, exactly. So they are swimming in the water with a flare.
Yeah.
And
there's a song, too.
Them.
There's a light, like a song.
A siren
song. Thank you.
A siren song, which you really just go away from, not towards. But in this case, you go towards the merperson. And then there's an option once you get to that merperson to return back to your ship. So we did that. And it turns out we spawned back at the beginning.
But when you do that, you can't bring your chest. And what we discovered when this happened to us.
Yeah, this happened. Something similar happened to Jeff and I.
I can't remember exactly what. It might have been. We came to an island where there were there were skeletons.
Yes, I got attacked by a skeleton.
That were launching cannons. And we jumped off. And I think that. They sunk the ship.
Yeah. The skeletons sunk.
Yeah.
Him?
Yeah. And so then we went to teleport back.
Yeah.
And what ended up happening is, we realized, okay, there's no, we were streaming actually. And people were like, you're not going to be able to bring the chest with you. But everyone in the comments.
Craig Duncan was watching. Yes. The head of Rare was watching our stream. This is last week.
We were very incompetent.
The pressure of that.
Well, we found a bug.
Yeah. So the. But we were told, they were like, come back, the chest will be there. The chest will be there.
And the chest was there.
It was there.
No.
We went back. It took us a little while to find it, and we weren't able to.
The problem was, the ship?
No, it was basically suspended underwater, but we couldn't pick it up. It was like invisible, or like we would swim through it.
Indivisible.
Indivisible.
So this happened to me later. I was flying solo, and I found a chest. And during that time, someone came over. They saw me. They saw my ship. They didn't know where I was, and they just lit up my ship and took off. So what it is, I placed it on a very specific rock that I thought was out of the way but easy for me to find again. And I went to the merperson. I sailed back to that island and the treasure and the chest was sitting right there.
Oh,
and
really?
I was able to bring it back and cash it in.
Interesting. So if the ship disappears, the chest will appear where the ship had disappeared? Like in the water?
I don't know if I had kept the chest on the ship, then I'm not sure what would have happened.
Right.
But what happened is I had no ship and so I essentially
re-hit it. You put the chest down.
Yeah, I put the chest down
and then teleported back to
exactly.
Your ship. Okay.
Yeah, because if you're holding it, actually, I think what happened that time is we were swimming with it and went to the merperson and it teleported me without it and we went back and it was roughly in that spot.
Yeah, it was roughly in that spot, right.
So pro tip, put your chest down before you teleport.
Yeah. Or to make it even better, pro tip, leave somebody on the ship.
Yeah. Don't lose your ship in the first place.
Don't lose your ship in the first place.
Ounce of prevention.
So it's a lot. So you saw the beauty and the awesomeness that was Sea of Thieves, which is the closed beta this week. I think it's over by the time the show will be up, right?
It's over this minute. Yes.
Yeah.
Well, it is a gorgeous game, I must say.
Yeah.
I was appreciating the sunset, and then when it became dark, the skeletons came out.
Yeah. Oh, well. Yeah.
I didn't know skeletons come out at night, but they came out and they found me and I had to run away.
Will find you.
Yes,
they will. Yeah, no, you know, we talked about it. The closed beta was a lot of fun. We played a lot. Jeff and I streamed it a little bit. We had a lot of fun with it. It is beautiful. You know, the storms are real. Seasick is a real issue.
It's a real thing.
Do you get seasick?
Yes, I do.
You do?
I am really sensitive to motion sickness.
Oh, wow. Okay.
But fortunately, when I was playing, I didn't feel motion sick, but
right.
Anybody who was watching me couldn't stand in the room for a minute.
Yeah, it can be a little brutal, but
I didn't have any problems with it.
So I am going to go on record as saying when it releases in March, we will play, Laura. You and I and Jeff will find a fourth. Maybe we'll get E in here, but mm-hmm. I promise you we will play. Okay. We will schedule. Your schedule's busy, mine's busy, Jeff's busy, but we need to do this.
We do need to do this.
I'm not that busy.
yes, you're hunting monsters, and we'll talk about that in a minute. Yeah. What else are you playing, Laura?
So that is pretty much it. The other thing only other game I played this week was, strange enough, jumping back into Dance Central 3.
Oh, strangely enough. Strange for who? That'd be strange for me,
strange
not
for
you.
Maybe. But it turns out I actually didn't get into Dance Central 3. I thought I had, and I had completed the story, but I think
there's
there's a story.
Do you have to save the gym? You know, the local rec center from the big bad developer?
Well, there's a joke about that in the story,
but
I didn't realize there was a story. So when I went back to Dance Central 3, I found it. And it turns out you are time-traveling dance crime agents.
Time traveling dance crime. I do remember this, yes.
Yes. So you go back in time and you're trying to figure out the crazes of that time period. So you go back to the 70s and you're trying to discover what the crazes are and you're trying to nail these moves.
So they're disco. It's
the
70s. And
there's a dance battle at the end.
They're 70s.
Oh, yeah. That's what the 70s is. So
the late 70s.
Spoiler, it was the hustle. So they make you discover the hustle. And then you
listening to XM49.
Hey.
And then you dance the hustle at the end. And then you're done with the 70s. And you teleport back to the present. Then you got to go back to the 80s. And then there was a joke about trying to save the local gym.
Oh, okay, good.
So it was in there.
Anyway.
It was in there. But it was really fun. I had a lot of fun.
Good.
Dancing all the songs I actually didn't get to when mm-hmm. I was playing Dance Central.
Fun. Yeah,
that was fun.
So that's what you're playing.
Yeah.
Yeah. As we talked a little bit earlier, playing Sea of Thieves now over. I'm headed out to Rare next week. Talk about that later in the show. Playing PUBG. They announced last week 4 million folks playing PUBG on Xbox, which is a big, big deal. So,
congrats, PUBG.
And to celebrate that, anybody that purchased the game by the end of, I believe it's the end of January, they get 30,000 battle points, which is a lot of battle points, Laura. So go check your, go sign into PUBG and you should look in the upper right hand corner and you should have enough to go on a shopping spree to get yourself a sweet set of kicks, as Jeff says.
Or, you know, or to just shoot your friend in the back.
Oh, no, we're not going to talk about this, are we?
What?
Well, I just happened to bring up when we had played earlier this week.
Have you seen this?
No, what happened?
Oh, my God. Well, we broadcast on Mixer.
Oh, look, you were streaming.
Yeah. And here's the exact part where Larry stabs me in the back literally with a gun.
What happened, Larry?
And,
So I...
Oh, no.
I am not much for precision in that game in terms of in the heat of the moment, I will just let it rip. And this has happened. It actually has happened. Laura, consider yourself lucky. Every single person I have been playing with recently has fallen to my
friendly fire.
Bullets. So I apologize.
I see. Yes, since the heat of the moment, you were trying to
save him when in fact I killed
Rubes,
him.
Mm-hmm. When in fact the opposite happened.
In a lot of ways.
Oh, no.
I'll link out to that.
So anyway, you don't need to.
Oh, no.
So playing a lot of PUBG, Overwatch, 4K Overwatch update is out. Jeff, we need to get back into that. I know you played a little bit of that.
Yeah,
I played a little bit of that as well. So we're doing that. That's kind of what's doing. It's been a lot of that going on.
Absolutely.
And Jeff, I got into Monster Hunter. I started it. The character creation is overwhelming. It's spectacular.
Yes,
but
yes.
You got deeper into it than I did, right?
It's true. I'd never played a Monster Hunter game, and they've been going on for quite some time, but I had been reading that this was a very accessible version, at least by Monster Hunter standards. And so I jumped in over the weekend, went through that character creator and cat character creator.
Yeah, you make a kitty cat.
Beginning. Oh, you get to be a cat at the beginning?
Oh, well, you have a cat sidekick at all times, but these are cats that run on 2 feet. Cook delicious dishes. By the way, this is like my favorite. But the best part of the game is when you go to the cook and he makes you something.
Mm-hmm.
Have you seen this animation?
No. Is it like the Zelda one?
Imagine you were being your delicious meal was being prepared by a trio of culinary cats.
Oh.
I can't think of any other words here I would do.
Wow.
And it's just so funny. And it's just like, it is my everything at this point. I'm also allergic to cats. This is really the closest I get to really be with them. But it's a pretty cool game. It's a game that I can definitely see myself getting sucked into. I think it demands your time. There's systems upon systems, and you immediately start by choosing like one of 14 different weapons. I'm like, okay, I don't know which weapon's going to be good.
It's complicated.
There's a lot to it.
And they're kind of silly comic book oversized.
Oh my God.
Yes. Like I pulled one out and I was like, what? This thing was like four times the size
of my
character.
Did you pick the katana?
Maybe.
We all pick the katana first. They feel like the katana's 10 feet long. You know, it makes Cloud from Final Fantasy VII look like he's carrying like a pocket watch.
It's ridiculous.
Or a pocket watch. But, what I will link out to, if you're interested in the game, I will say yes, it's definitely the most accessible of any Monster Hunter that has come out. And there is a polygon put together like a, here's what you need to know in the first 10 hours. It's written by 8-4. These are folks, they do localization for a lot of Japanese games for America. Some good folks, actually hung out with them when I was in Japan recently. And they wrote a pretty comprehensive guide for Polygon. So if you think you've jumping into the game, highly recommend it. I'll link out to it in the notes. Having a good time with it.
I look forward to getting into that. But like I say, I'm headed out, traveling to Rare next week to go. I've never been to Rare. You've been, right?
Yeah, I've been. You've not been.
I have never been.
I thought you had.
I have never been. I have an open invitation for 10 plus years and I've never had a chance to
really?
Get out there. I know. Now I'm going out there.
Where did you get your pirate name from?
When they came here, we were doing something. I don't even remember. It was Matt, Admiral Nelson, right?
Yeah,
and what was yours, Jeff?
Rum Rubenstein.
That's right. That sounds about right.
There we go.
What was yours, Laura?
Mine was Seven Lashes, Laura.
So what we're talking about is like years
awkward
ago.
Awkward pause.
We got that is interesting.
I went there and they gave me a pirate name.
Yeah.
And that was what it was.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. They let us, you know, see the game, you know, some time ago in order, you know, before announced to just sort of take a look and share some feedback and stuff like that. And for everyone who participated, they put together a little pirate poster. They took a picture of you and sort of photoshopped you as a pirate and gave you a pirate name. They're all on board on the pirate. They're going all out.
They've been going all
out. Well, I just got
years.
A text. You know, it's funny. I'm sitting here and I just got a text from my wife who is actually shopping and she's sending me, Laura,
pictures of shirts.
Pirate shirts. So she's like, this will be good for your trip to Rare next week.
Have fun storming the castle.
And I've got...
Yeah. Oh, wow, that is...
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, so stay tuned.
I think I want to keep that one.
Stay tuned. Nice. Anyway, well, I'll give you more details on what that's all about. It's coming soon. So there you go about that.
Yeah, that should be a really fun trip.
We've got a lot of news this week. We talked a little bit about it. PUBG update. We've got an Overwatch update. Yeah. Jeff, you have some more updates to kind of manage and tell us all about and whatnot.
Yeah, I do. One update that I thought was pretty interesting, I know a lot of folks were really excited about, was to see that Moana characters were coming to Minecraft.
Now, for those of you that don't know, Moana is from?
Polynesia, maybe? It's a Disney movie.
It's a Disney movie. Stars Dwayne Johnson.
Dwayne the Rock Johnson. Other people as well. And you can use him. I think his character was named Maui.
Uh-huh.
And there was like a chicken. And I'm just looking at, and obviously Moana you can use. So that I'd imagine it might be, there's a pretty high crossover between Moana fans and Minecraft fans.
Mm-hmm.
So I think, oh, there's even like the crab that was voiced by the dude from, what was that New Zealand show? It's going to drive me nuts.
Uh-oh.
Anyway, they've won Oscars. It was like sort of like a parody.
The Flight of the Conchords?
Flight of the Conchords.
Okay.
Yes. Thank you.
How did you get, same page.
There's not a lot of New Zealand mockumentary, like sort of fake novelty.
Well, to be clear, I think that's the only one from New Zealand I would ever know. I was just waiting for him to say enough data for me to go, that's the one.
Yeah, but this is why we got it. Anyway, so that was just announced, and actually, yeah, you can just go in there and get after it.
Yay.
So it is available now. So another update since we last spoke. Where the announcement of the Xbox Live games with gold for February. So by the time you're listening to this, you'll be able to get them.
Yeah.
So for Xbox One, at the beginning of February, will be Shadow Warrior. And then February 16th will be Assassin's Creed Chronicles India. and then through backward compatibility, Split Second. Did you ever play this game?
I did.
No.
It was a fun game. It was like a racing game that had a lot of like epic moments with like cutscenes. So you're driving through a factory where like things are falling apart all over the place. It was a pretty cool game. And then keeping that theme going, Crazy Taxi.
Good old Crazy Taxi.
On the old Dreamcast. Mm-hmm. Man, what a great game that was. And so, so both of those were Xbox 360 games, which are available through the magic of backward compatibility and coming this month free for gold members.
You know, we didn't have this show last week, so we can take a moment to talk about the updates to Game Pass.
That's right.
Jeffrey, big stuff coming. Yeah. You saw this?
Yeah, so this is a huge announcement.
Yeah.
Game-changing announcement, and that is Xbox Game Pass members will be able to play our first party releases, such as Sea of Thieves,
right,
such as State of Decay,
right,
such as Crackdown 3, State of Decay 2, I should say, when they come out, day one.
Then, yeah.
And so it was already, I would say, probably just about the best value in gaming, about 100, you know, for $10 a month, you have access to like about 150 games, which you can download, you don't have to stream. And for our first party games to be available on that, our new ones on day one, like, it's kind of a no-brainer.
Yeah, so that's that was all the news. I have all the information up at news.xbox.com or over at my blog at Major Nelson. So you're a Game Pass subscriber, right? Laurel, you don't need to be because you get a lot of games, right?
I probably should be one. Yeah, it's 150 games.
Yeah, why not?
There's some really good, and they're constantly updating. And so, like, you know, we're coming up, like, Darksiders 3 is going to be coming out pretty soon. Mm-hmm. And so they recently made the Xbox One remaster of Darksiders. One had already been there, Darksiders 2. So you can play through those two games getting ready for Darksiders 3.
Are you getting ready?
I played a little bit of Darksiders 1, and I really need to go back because, like, they're really well loved. And, like, from what I've heard about the games, they're kind of like Zelda-esque, like old school Zelda-esque.
Yeah.
I don't know why I haven't played them. Another game.
Yes.
There's another beta. So last week it was all about the Sea of and this week it was all about the Sea of Thieves beta. Right now we are in the middle of the Age of Empires Definitive Edition beta.
Oh, I need to download that so I can play it on the plane.
So
I can play when I'm traveling.
Good idea.
So that's for Windows 10.
Yep.
If you haven't gotten into there at this point, because it's already started, the way to get in would be to pre-order the game. And then you can go on there and you know, people are going to be streaming it. You'll be able to see all that. If you miss out on that, we're still only less than 3 weeks away from release to be out February 20th.
Yep.
So definitely looking forward to that. That was the first sort of like RTS type game I had ever played.
A lot of people, a lot of people did that as well. Yeah.
On my 46.
I think my first was Warcraft.
That was good too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's a good game.
I don't even know what mine was. I'm completely blind. I put myself on the spot here. I don't know. So. I think I've actually on that one.
Maybe Command and Conquer.
Could be.
Oh yeah.
Could be. That's
I was really so good. Into those that both of those.
Yeah. Really?
Really enjoyed Command and Conquer.
You didn't think that's the type of game? That's why I like Halo Wars.
Yeah. Okay, that's right. You do like you some Halo Wars, so.
Yep.
A couple other pieces of news from the ID at Xbox side. Announcement of a game that looks really cool that's going to be coming to Xbox One soon is this Roguevania called Dead Cells. So I've just been seeing a lot. I'm going to link to it. It looks really cool.
I've played lots of Dead Cells.
Oh, you have?
It's a favorite in our house. It is a roguelike, right, where it's every time you play, the world is different. But you accrue gold and you accrue skills that you can keep past your deaths. And it's got a fantastic graphics. It's sort of old school, but still looks really fancy graphics. And it's a really fun gameplay.
I'd heard
good
things.
Lots of repeatability for sure.
Yeah.
All right.
So
fun.
That will be coming out soon. Couple of other games that have hit in the last week. Wolverblade Railway Empire. This just seems like something you would be into alongside your, you know, farming simulator. I think driving
trains.
Did you
trains. See me? I played that the other day. I was playing Farming Simulator.
Farming Simulator, I believe, also Which part one? Of Xbox Game Pass.
I don't know what it was. All I know is I was out plowing a field and I brought the tractor around and realized I should never plow a field again. I looked like I was under the influence.
Did you have to hook up the plow to the tractor?
Yes.
That's one of the hardest parts.
Yeah, it was.
To get the plow hooked up and then adding the front weight so that it doesn't.
Anyway, a little too much information. You know a little too much about this. Why do
you know I like the Farming Simulator game?
Well, that's because I think you've done most of this in real life. That's the strange part. You are but a farmer.
Yes. Well,
farmer's daughter.
My family does have a ranch with some tractors.
Right. I want to go down there and just drive them around.
Yeah. My father will be happy to teach you about how to drive the tractor.
Yeah,
he'll give you a task like go pull down that tree.
On the way.
It's really fun.
All right, I'm sorry, Jeff. We got sidetracked with tractor talk.
Another game that came out last week, which this one I'll admit flew completely under my radar. People are already talking about it as a potential game of the year candidate, an early one. Celeste. So this is a really challenging platformer, like in the vein of like a Super Meat Boy or something like that, where it's for the people that made Towerfall, which was very well loved when it came out a few years ago, debuted on the Ouya. Anyway, so this game is available. It's a relatively inexpensive title that is an ID at Xbox title that just people are talking about it. I wouldn't judge it by the screens, which make it look like, I mean, it is a platform. I've seen some videos. It looks like incredibly challenging. You sort of bend your mind to think like you come into a screen and it's like, how could I ever do that? And then you watch someone do it and it's like, well, that's how you do it. I think we'll see some amazing runs at like Summer Games Done Quick on this one. But anyway, getting a ton of buzz. So keep an eye out for Celeste.
Cool.
And that's pretty much it. Oh, EA Sports UFC 3 is also now available for Xbox One.
All right. Delightful.
It's a lot of news.
A lot of news. I wish you had joined us on our stream when we were doing Sea of Thieves.
That would have been fun.
We had,
just couldn't make it work.
No, that's fine. We just, Jeff and I had quite the time on the high seas.
Did you do the two-player version?
Yeah, we just did the two-player, two-player ship.
Yes, there is a two-player ship, which is more nimble.
There's a one and two-player ship, which is the same ship, and then there's the four-player, which is...
I didn't do the single-player ship.
Well, the four-player ship is massive.
Yeah. It's really big.
It's a boat.
Yeah, for sure. Did you guys do the single-player? Have you tried that out yet?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I've gone on a few missions, and it feels lighter and whatnot.
Is there a cannon on the single...
Yeah, there's one on each side.
There's one on each side. Okay. You're not going to really want to use. No. You're not, unless you're fighting another ship of equal size. You're better off just running and hiding. It's great for like moving quickly. And I ran a number of solo missions. I wanted to try it out on Windows 10 because it was a game that you seamlessly can play from one to the other. It worked out great. And I just was running around in the solo ship and cashed in a few treasures and leveled up my faction standing.
When's that coming out, Jeff?
It's coming out March 20th.
March 20th. So we're
one
just
one month after Age of Empires.
Month and a half or so. A little under a month and a half, 2 months away.
Yeah.
Awesome.
It's going to be real exciting.
We're going to do a little bit of, we're cooking along on this show. We don't have any special guests this week. You, listener, are our special guest because we can devote more time to you. All right, name the game. We're going to give folks another week to win that.
That's right.
So here's the name the game sound from the last time, but we're going to give you another chance, okay? Because very few people got it right.
It was a hard one this time.
All right, so
we'll give you another try. Here we go.
All right, that was Name the Game from a couple weeks ago. We're giving you guys another chance. We like to do that when only a few people get right, because we want to make sure
If you already answered,
yes,
don't worry about it.
Yep.
We got your entry.
Yeah, you're
but
still
if
in.
You didn't get a chance to answer.
Now's your chance. You get a second chance.
Second chance.
There's very few second chances in life, Laura.
That's true.
Okay, we're giving you one.
That's true.
We're giving you one. So there you go.
If you think you know what game those sounds are from, send me an email, lollipop@xbox.com and cc@xbox.com.
That's all I got to do. Don't mention it on Twitter because it doesn't count as an entry.
That's correct.
You can say hello to us on Twitter, but it doesn't count as an entry.
That's right. You have to send us an email.
Mm-hmm.
The email.
Are you around next week? Oh, I'm not around next week. So
you're going to.
Yeah,
you're gone the whole week?
Well, I'm leaving on Tuesday, land there Wednesday.
You're gone the whole week.
I'm there the whole week.
It takes at least a day.
It's a schlep.
You're going to take in a soccer match? And a lot of like
I can't do that
transfers.
Without you.
Oh, okay.
I can't do that without you.
You're going to be in a soccer rich area.
I very much so.
There's a lot of teams around there.
I would love if I'm there, and I'm flying back on Saturday, so I'm missing the football day.
Yeah, that's a big, yeah. Might be some Friday night matches. I'll do some research for you.
Anyway, I was going to say, if you guys want to do a show or stream, you're welcome to, Laura, Jeff, as I look at you both.
Without you? You're the straw that
stirs
the drink.
No, I'm not. I'm the bubbles in your soda.
Well, no. But it wouldn't be soda without the bubbles.
That's true.
It would just be flat.
It takes every part of what we have here. You are all part of the ingredients. And that make
are you saying you might want to stream from the UK?
I would love to. I just don't think I'll have time because my schedule there is pretty, pretty, pretty packed.
I imagine it is packed.
Yeah. Also, we don't have Sea of Thieves, so I don't know what we would be like, hey, Rare, do you mind if we load up Overwatch or PUBG?
Yeah, that would not cool. Although I could just stream from my, I've got the Mixer app, Mixer Create on my phone.
And I'm sure you'll do it.
I can just go bam to a few million people.
You know what you did back when Periscope was new?
Yes.
I mean, getting used to living in a live world. I remember you just went through the prices of all the things.
Oh, when I play the prices right on the minibar.
Yeah. And it was funny. It's like that was the number one thing on Periscope at that moment.
Right.
It was crazy how many people were watching that.
I should do that again. You never saw that, Laura.
No,
did you?
I didn't see it.
It's because, you know, when you travel, usually in a hotel, most hotels, they have like a minibar and the stuff is so ridiculously expensive.
Yes.
I did the prices right using, how much is this Snickers bar? Oh, it's $1, $2, $3. No, it's $7.99. It's like ridiculous prices.
I think it's called something else over there.
What, the mini bar?
No, Snickers.
Oh, I don't know. It's the I don't know. Maybe I'll do that when I'm over there. It's a good idea.
Yeah, sounds fun.
So anyway, so if you guys want to do something next week, but we've got to wrap up the show in a little bit because Laura's got to run to a meeting. I've got to run. Jeff has to.
I just sit here until next week. Twiddling my thumbs, waiting for the next show.
You want to talk about some technology though?
We haven't talked about tech in a while.
We haven't.
No.
So what do you want to talk about?
Well, I got the best Christmas present that I didn't expect.
Did you hear about this, Laura?
No.
This is Jeff.
So I got two. So I got back from a long trip. We were in Japan, and I got back on New Year's Eve, give or take. And then I was given a gift, and I was like, well, what is this? Some close friends got me an Ember. An Ember is a coffee cup that keeps your coffee warm.
Ooh.
And this, and I was like, first I was like, this is the dumbest thing I've ever seen. You have to, first I had to update the firmware on my coffee cup, which is like some real Black Mirror stuff
firmware
right there. Yeah. Oh yeah.
A coffee cup.
I've seen everything now, but
yeah,
on a Saturday morning when I have coffee, a lot of times what I do is I spend the morning usually playing Overwatch in the house.
With his daughter.
And I only have a chance to sip when I die, not that often. and I have 6 seconds. And, and so that cup will last an hour. And normally by the end of the time, if I've played 3 or 4 matches, that coffee's cold. Well, no more.
No more.
Stays at a crisp.
This first world problem has been solved.
130 degrees, and you can adjust it. It has an app.
It's too hot. Wow.
There's an app for the coffee cup.
Because
you can change the LED color.
Believe me, I came in saying this is the most ridiculous extra type of gift ever. But for the coffee person who thinks they have everything, this is the thing. It's a great gift. Nobody needs this.
Right.
But as a bizarre quality of life thing, I'm wasting a lot less coffee these days.
Awesome. How long does the battery last?
Probably about 90 minutes.
I think it's about an hour. Depends what your temperature is. Okay.
So just like the night before, I'll go ahead and I'll just put it on. The charger is a saucer, which is just a really nice touch.
So it's not a plug-in.
You plug the saucer into the wall.
And then you drop it on the saucer. We'll put a link in the show notes.
Yeah, I'll put it. It's the strange, but you know what? I love it.
Ironically, I don't drink coffee. I drink espresso, which is a very different type of drink. It's a much more classier type of drink.
Yeah, except that you drink it like a shot. It's gone in like 10 seconds.
Yeah, that's true. So anyway, so my wife drinks coffee. So I actually bought her one of these, unbeknownst that Jeff had one.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so when he was tweeting it out, I sent him a photo that, yeah, so she loves it too.
So you know all about it.
Yeah, I was like, wow, that's weird.
So there are LED lights on the cup?
Yeah, there's a little one at the bottom.
And you can change the color of it.
Yeah.
Mine's purple.
Yeah, what is the?
Like now, so did you get did you get the travel one or the white ceramic one?
The white ceramic one.
Yeah.
Wait, I didn't know they had a travel one.
Yeah, no, they have a travel one, and it's got a dial on the bottom to dial up the. You didn't know they have a travel one?
No, I don't know these things.
Yeah, well, that's. Now
you can put that on your birthday list.
Yeah.
You can get it as another gift.
Well,
travel version.
Oh, look at that! Now I'm gonna have to. Man, you just cost me money.
It's expensive. It's like twice as expensive as the regular.
Nobody needs this. But
Ember.
Awesome.
Ember. Well, I don't need one of those.
I'll just I'll put a link to it. It's just really bizarre, but kind of great.
Do you have anything you want to talk about on the technology side, Laura?
I'm trying to think if I've gotten anything new, and I don't think I have.
Yeah, the last thing I got, you know, the Razer phone. I've been playing around with the Razer phone. Right. Razer sent me a couple of their new keyboards, one in this crazy pink.
Cool.
Did they send you any of the Diva stuff they make? Like the headset?
No.
They have a whole Diva line. Yeah. Diva from Overwatch.
And I know your daughter's a big Diva fan.
Diva costs me a lot of money every month.
Yeah.
Whether it be loot boxes or t-shirts or whatever.
In merchandise or otherwise. So yeah, I haven't really done anything. I'm working on some more home networking stuff that I'm always futzing.
You're always
I'm always futzing.
That.
Is that the proper term?
That's some good Yiddish there, Larry.
I know. Well,
oh, God. Mazel tov.
You're
futzing.
I'm always futzing, but I need to stop futzing. But yeah, I've got a few more things that I'm working on. I got one of you know, at the Amazon show. Have you seen the Amazon?
No.
So that's the Amazon Alexa with the screen.
Oh, okay.
So when we play Jeopardy now, it's you now have the question right in front of you.
Oh, so you can read the question.
Right, you can, in addition to her telling you, so it doesn't make it easier.
Did you know that if you're on Prime, you can play the previous days of Jeopardy?
Yes.
Which makes things
And you get extra questions.
Yes.
But I will say this, with a show, I'm convinced that the questions are actually harder than if you don't have it. Like I think it's a different set of questions because they're asking this. I'm like, we got like 4 out of 12. Right?
Yeah, I played three previous right? days, and they were much harder.
Yeah, if you have Alexa, then you need to add this.
They actually have one also that we did. This is an escape room that you can do. It plays out like an old school text adventure where you're literally like, look forward on Alexa. Like, look forward and you see, and you have to escape from one thing. You have to escape from an office that you're locked into. Another one, you wake up in a car where that has been somehow boarded up and you have to escape from it. It's kind of fun.
Remember I was telling about the escape room we did?
Yes.
Jeff was with me.
Oh, you were in the escape room.
I was telling Laura about it because she would totally dig this.
Oh, yeah.
We did one here in Seattle, Jeff and I and our teams last week. And
I'd love to do that.
They were really elaborate. Like one, you had to escape from prison, basically. Cool. And there's like, you're in individual cells with like steel bar. It was,
it
was kind of nuts. Another one.
Well, so with that one, I don't want to give too much away. Yeah. I don't know if I told you this, Laura, but yeah, I think I did. We, with that one, Jeff, when we did it, I was in we got locked in different cells. There were 4 cells and 2 in each. And one part of the cell is, or one part of the puzzle, the beginning is you have to find the key, which is this long rod, remember?
Yeah.
And you have to push it into the hole to unlock the secret door.
Yep.
Well, unbeknownst to me, when we got loaded up into our cells, my cellmate, who will remain nameless, they had a water bottle, and they put it over the hole.
Oh, no.
So we could not find it until all of a sudden we removed it. And we're like, oh, here it is. So it was, but it was a lot of fun.
That's why they don't allow bottled water,
in jails.
In jail.
Now you know. More you know.
That sounds super.
Anyway,
fun.
Puzzle rooms. What else? So yeah, that's about it. I'm working on a few more projects. I got so much technology that I got to look at. I'm hoping to get my hands on the new Surface. I don't have the new Surface Book yet. And a bunch of you called that out on when we did the stream last week. The Surface Book 2.
Which has a pretty nice graphics card in there. You can run some games on
Sea of Thieves when I'm on the way.
So just go talk to the Surface team.
Hopefully we'll get a hold of that and a few other things. But anyway, we're gonna wrap the show up. We wanted to get together and give you a show. It's a highlight of my week to hang out in a small windowless room with Laura and Jeff. So hopefully it's the highlight of yours as well. Jeffrey?
Definitely.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
Are
you
looking at the travel thing?
You're looking at the over-under on the game this weekend, aren't you?
I'm also looking at there's some interesting soccer stuff trending. This is the last day of the transfer window, Larry. It's important. But I'm looking at this travel mug. You just cost me money.
All right, there you go. Order that. All right. We won't see you next week because I'm headed to Rare, and Jeff and Laura can barely get here when I'm doing the show. They're not going to get here by themselves. We'll work on a video show for you in the future, and a lot of good stuff planned for this year. So you can find us on social. You can find Jeffrey at
Jeff Rubenstein.
That's also the complaint desk, and you can find Laura.
I am at Laura Lollicott.
That's the suggestion desk. I'm Larry here of Xbox Live's Major Nelson. You can find me at Major Nelson. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye-bye. Bye.